Recommendation 3 of the What Works Clearinghouse Practice Guide, Assisting Students Struggling with Mathematics Intervention in the Elementary Grades, supports the use of concrete and semi-concrete representations as students are learning mathematical concepts and procedures. The What Works Clearinghouse and the expert panel assigned a strong level of evidence to this recommendation, meaning that there is consistent evidence that meets What Works Clearinghouse standards and indicates that the practice improves outcomes for diverse student populations. Concrete representations are physical materials that students can move, build with, and manipulate to model mathematical ideas or relationships. These can include base 10 blocks, square tiles, pattern blocks, Cuisenaire rods, and so on. Semi-concrete representations are the two-dimensional illustrations of the concrete models. Some semi-concrete representations would include strip diagrams, tables, graphs, number lines, and drawings, among others. Abstract representations are those that we typically think of when we think about mathematics. These include numbers, operation signs, and relational symbols, such as the equal sign, greater than, or less than. Concrete and semi-concrete representations especially bring the mathematics to life in visual ways that cannot be done using only abstract symbols. The practice guide provides 4 action steps to use representations. First, and most importantly, choose the representation wisely. Not all representations work well with every mathematical concept or procedure. For example, if you are modeling place value, you want to choose a concrete material that shows the proportional relationship between the place value positions rather than using one that does not represent the relationship proportionally. Second, the 3 representations should be presented at the same time. That is, as students model with concrete materials, they can then draw the model they made and write the corresponding mathematical representation using numbers and symbols. For example, if students model regrouping with base 10 blocks, they should sketch the blocks and the actions they took and write the equation. By doing this, students are able to connect the representations and better understand the relationships modeled. Third, consistent use of representations, especially concrete and semi-concrete, enhance student thinking. Students should view them as tools rather than toys that they play with. They will also come to recognize and use them as ways to support and explain a solution strategy they may have used to solve a problem. Using representations enhances and brings depth to students' explanations and helps those listening to the explanations make sense of the solution process being shared. As students connect the mathematical ideas and the ways they are represented, they develop a deeper understanding of the mathematics. Finally, the concurrent use of concrete, semi-concrete, and abstract representations help to deepen students' understanding of the mathematics, regardless of their age or grade level. Students will come to recognize the importance of representations that can assist them when they are unsure of how to proceed in solving a problem. This builds confidence and competence within students as they understand the tools they have to use as needed.